The moderator and my dear brothers and sisters, I am grateful for this opportunity to complete the 1 hour allotted to each. My brother Wakefield has made so many points, so many statements, and in 10 minutes no human being can respond to them all. But beginning at the beginning, at the very beginning, he repeated the formula, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. All. Implying that everybody, no exception. I mean, that's what it means in English. All means all. But this is giving a lie to Jesus. Paul is giving a lie to Jesus. Jesus Christ, in the Gospel of St. Matthew, Chapter 2, verse 35, he says, that upon you may come all the righteous blood shed on the earth, from the blood of righteous Abel unto the blood of Zacharias, to the Jews. So woe unto you Jews, woe unto you Jerusalem, you kill the prophets. You kill the prophets. From righteous Abel, righteous. Righteous means sinless. Abel to righteous Zechariah, you kill the prophets. Then in the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 1, it speaks about righteous Zechariah. Zechariah was righteous in the sight of the Lord, means upright. In the book of Luke again, first chapter, it says Elizabeth was righteous in the sight of the Lord. If a person is righteous, then he's not destined for hell, according to the testimony given by Jesus and Luke, supposed to be inspiring at the inspiration of the Holy Ghost. With regards to the fulfillment of prophecies, the bishop said that, you know, Jesus was the Almighty God, the Wonderful Counselor, and he called Emmanuel, Emmanuel, called Emmanuel, Jesus. Here, I have this Bible here. It is the same Bible as I take it as you have, King James Version. There are 27 books of the New Testament, 27. And in those 27 books, nowhere is Jesus ever addressed, he shall be called. That means you shall take his name. He shall be called Emmanuel. Nobody ever called him Emmanuel in his life. I would like to see somebody. With regards, to the expression I am, that Jesus said I am, and God said I am, God didn't say I am. He said Ehaye. When Moses asked him, what is your name? He said Ehaye Asher Ehaye. That is in the Hebrew language. This is what God gave him. Ehaye Asher Ehaye means I am whatever I am. Now the translation into the Greek Bible, into your Greek manuscripts, that I am is ho-on, ho-on, I am, ho-on. But in the New Testament, the Greek translation says that I am is ego-eimi, ego-eimi. Coming from the same Holy Ghost, I can't understand that if that I am stood for God, for Jesus also it should have been ho-on and not ego-eimi. Referring to the Quran, that the Quran says that it was the Jews that didn't kill him, and most probably it is implied that the Gentiles might have killed him. But in the verse that I read to you, it says وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا, for of a surety they killed him not in any way, any form, either by crucifixion or by poisoning or by spearing. In no way was he killed at all. Three days and three nights. You see, the Christians say the miracle of Jonah is not that he was dead or alive, but the time factor. He repeated the word 3-4 times. He said, for as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the belly of the earth. Very, very distinct, very, very clear. 3 days, three nights, 3 days, three nights. Don't make a mistake. 72 hours, 72 hours, 3 days and three nights. And I'm asking the Christians, let's see, did he fulfill that? Did he fulfill that? When was he crucified? Anybody knows? When was Christ crucified? Friday afternoon. Right? Not Friday morning, Friday afternoon. And they had to give him a burial bath, which takes a couple of hours. Then they had to put 100 pound weight of medicines around him. That's what John tells us, 100 pound of weight of medicines. And they had to put a shroud around him and then put him into the sepulcher. It's already evening. By the time they put him into the sepulcher, it is already evening. So Saturday night, this is the Jewish calculation, night first, then the day. Same thing in Islam. Our Ramadan comes, the Ramadan night is the first, then the day, night, day. In the Jews, night, day, night, not day and night. The Westerners say day and night, we say no, night and day, night and day. So Friday night, he's supposed to be in the grave. Watch my finger, Friday night. Saturday day, he's still supposed to be in the grave. Saturday night, he's still supposed to be in the grave. Sunday morning, the first day of the week, Sunday morning, when Mary goes to Magdalene, goes to the tomb is empty. It's already empty. Morning, in the morning, it's already empty. I'm asking, how many days and how many nights? Can you people see? Can you see? No, can you count? I want to know whether you can count. Look, Friday night, Saturday day, Saturday night, Sunday morning, first day of the week, the tomb is empty. How many days and how many nights? Two nights and a day. Is that the same as this? Look, he said 3 and 3, 2 and 1. 3 and 3, 2 and 1. Is it the same? In any language. How you try, the master mathematician Einstein can't even help you here. Please. Jesus returns to that upper room after his alleged crucifixion. And he goes inside and he wishes his disciples Shalom Aleichem in Hebrew. Salam Aleichem. Peace be unto you. And when he said peace be unto you, his disciples were terrified. I'm asking, why were they terrified? Because when you meet your long lost master, your uncle, your grandfather, the Arab and the Jew, he embraces one another, he kisses one another. But instead of that, the disciples of Jesus were terrified. So I want to know, why were they terrified? So Luke tells us that they were affrighted because they thought he was a spirit. I'm asking, did he look like a spirit? And the Christians say no. Then why should they think the man is a spirit when he didn't look like one? The reason is because the disciples of Jesus, they had heard from hearsay that the master was hanged on the cross. They had heard from hearsay that he had given up the ghost, meaning his spirit had come out, he had died. They had heard from hearsay that the man is buried for 3 days already, perhaps stinking in his grave. Such a person, you see, naturally, you are terrified. So Jesus wants to assure them that it is not what they are thinking. They are thinking he's come back from the dead. So Jesus says, behold my hands and my feet. Have a look at my hands and my feet. That it is I myself. I'm the same fellow man. Damn fools, what are you afraid of me for?